The locals have had enough and they're fighting to evict the serpents from their shore. Our science reporter Rebecca Morell finds out more.
It all started with one stowaway snake. But today on this tiny Pacific island, there are millions. The brown tree snake might not look like much of a menace, but this unwelcome guest has become Guam's nemesis.
There he is. This is a very typical size for a brown tree snake.
Yeah. Let me know when you feel comfortable. You feel comfortable because you got him.
This snake is one of the most successful invasive species in the world. Since it arrived in England 60 years ago, it's decimated the local wildlife. This forest here used to be full of sounds, and now it's silent.
There are now more than 6,000 snakes per square kilometer on Guam.
They prey on the small birds till they drop the bomb. It has switched its feeding preference. It basically goes after everything it can acquire here. We thought it would be limited at first in the cave. It wipes out the birds, populations will decline. It wasn't the case. It just switched what it was feeding on. So rodents, lizards, small mammals, across the board.
Now the locals are fighting back to save their beautiful island. Desperate times, though, call for desperate measures. This is an airdrop with a difference. Mice laden with poison are parachuted down to unsuspecting snakes below. It's the latest weapon in their war against the snakes, but it's a battle on two fronts. Conservationists are also trying to stop the reptiles from spreading to neighbouring islands. Dogs here have been trained to sniff out any unwanted hideaways. It's a huge task. Every item of cargo is checked before it leaves the island. But letting the snakes escape is not an option.
Researchers have gone to Hawaii and looked at their economy and tried to apply the impacts of the snake to Hawaii. And they found that it could result in up to $400 million U.S. or more per year. It includes health care for humans because the snakes have people. It includes damages to the power system. It includes lost revenue associated with declines in tourism. If you have a venomous snake now populating Hawaii, people aren't as likely to travel to Hawaii.
The infestation here is on such a colossal scale, it may well be too late to bring it under control. For now, Guam says it's an example to the world of what happens when an invasive species takes hold.
There you go.
Rebecca Morrell, BT News, Guam.
Thanks a lot.
And that's all from reporters for this week from me, Zainab Adalian. Goodbye for now.